Добрый день, уважаемые.
Good morning, dear participants in the International Financial Congress, dear colleagues. I'm happy to welcome you all here and to open our session as part of our discussion of strategic risks and new opportunities for the banking sector. First of all, I take the honor to introduce our speakers today. Петр Авен on our screen today.
Председатель совета директоров.
He is chairman of the board of directors of Alpha Bank.
Михаил Михайлович.
Михаил Задорнов, chairman of the board of Открытие Bank. Сергей Хотимский, first deputy chairman of the board of directors of Совком Bank, and also one of the shareholders of that bank. And Игорь Ясеновец, senior partner of McKinsey. So we have four speakers today, and one is a CEO, an executive officer of the bank. Two people are in charge of not only managing the banking sector, but they are also co-owners and shareholders of banks, which also kind of like shapes their attitudes, and a professional consultant, an expert who has been in the banking sector and in the business of consulting the banking sector for many years. Let me warn you, first of all, my dear colleagues and speakers, that this time of the pandemic dictates some of the peculiarities of our communication and discussion. This is not only about offline and online, but this is also about a time limit. I do not know whether we are going to be able to cover everything, but we are going to have some like blitz interviews and discussion. So please take the floor and share with us your ideas. Now, why are we talking about strategic risks? The banking industry and banking in the life of one generation, I actually entered this business in the mid-70s of last year, but since then, everything has changed. The landscape and the very essence of banking changed. This was not banking as usual in the past. This was more like a professional services sector. Then we had some containment of competition in many countries. Like within the country, you had like walls between the sectors of the economy, but also inside the financial sector, you had the walls and partitions. So there was some ban on the expansion of the business to other geographies, like cities and provinces, etc., to say nothing of some transborder operations. Then we come to the period of mass-scale deregulation in the second half of the 80s, and the banking has become a prospering business to compete with the other sectors of the economy for the money of investors. The investor money was flowing into the banking sector, which was kind of like a boost and a flourishing time for banking, and shares and stock, even of smaller banks, were sold at a price which was many-fold times higher than the initial price. That was before 1998. With the quite well-known event happening back then. Then in the interest of investors actually fell. Now we are selling that stock at 0.5, 0.6% times of what you had before. And then you have new competition for clients, not only in terms of pricing, but also in terms of nice packaging of those services. There's a question now, and some of the individual experts are quite pessimistic, some are optimistic, but the question is, what are the prospects for banking and for the banking sector? That's something that we're going to discuss. We would like to share your views, dear speakers, what the future holds for banks in the coming 5 years or 10 years. We're not going any farther in our forecast horizons, but if you are bold enough, please share your views about that far and away
такому вопросу. Причем,
time. So, I will be able to provide you with 3 minutes initially. For each of you, how do you see your bank and the banking sector in general in 5 years, 10 years? Is it going to be the classical lending and credit model, something that we started off with, or is it going to be something else and different? And potentially, what would be the existential challenges and risks to your business, to the investment attractiveness of your business? If banking is a business, then how do you see the future of your business? Peter, I hope that you can hear me well enough. First of all, I would like to say about this factor of 0.6. That's not really good enough. It's take Tinkoff or even Kaspi. It is not going to be even a 0.6 for some of the institutions. The story is quite telltaling and shows you where we are going. Now, we need to really see something new coming up, like partnership. A bank which used to live alone and independent and do everything by itself, but there you need to acquire new skills in 3 areas. First, you need to be able to integrate yourself in various fintech mechanisms, like payment, something that we have known for quite a while, and I thought that lending would be the business of traditional banks, but now you have also some lending engines, and you need to be able to integrate yourselves in the new technologies like fintech. The second area, you need also to acquire and take back some of the functions that were not the mandate of banks in the past, and you need to be able to make money on your partners like brokerage, or insurance, etc. And the third is some silent collaboration with the non-financial services, trying to integrate there as well. And if the classical bank today, well, it is quite obvious today that the main functions would be the brand name, which is good for the accumulation, also compliance to collect money, also risk management, because you need to manage your risks. The models are changing. Changing, and we are doing a lot, especially in the West, of wholesale lending, where you more or less issue money to the lending mechanisms and platforms that on lend to the end clients. But like payments and simple lending are a thing of the past. Alpha Bank today has 300 partnerships, big and small. And we understand that much of what we could have been doing ourselves, so we shouldn't be doing, because we have better partners there. For example, the voice engine of Yandex, it is much better than something that we would have come up with, and we are using our partners. Also, in the bank today, we have 100% of costs covered by the risk free revenue. However, we are also making money on partnerships. If you take Alpha Insurance, it brings more than 20 billion rubles in revenue from insurance. So the bank is an institution which needs to be skillful in building partnerships and an environment and a system. This is the obvious trend. It is changing quite heavily. Many of the institutions disappeared because they did not have the skills that are required today, unlike what you needed to have in the past. So like Uralsib, MDM, Bank of Moscow, these are the banks of the past. Those institutions cannot live in our today's world, and we need to be changing for the future. Thank you, Peter. I understand that you are quite confident about your future, at least about the future of your bank, under the leadership of such a wise central bank as Bank of Russia. Of course, I'm quite optimistic about my future. Well, thank you. for that, Piotr and Mikhail. What about you? Well, thank you for your question. And indeed, I do believe that banks will survive despite even this very deep transformation. They are still around, and we have had doubts in the past, and Piotr actually mentioned that banks would be able to kind of like take on high share of the market of the various other services, but this is something that we see today. This is already a big part of the revenues, but maybe mostly this is a big part of the liabilities. Now, what is going to happen? I think that we are going to see quite a heavy concentration of the financial sector, not only of the banking sector. The top 10 Russian banks hold almost 90% of the assets in public pension programs. The top six non-public pension funds hold 95% of assets. So we are going to see quite heavy concentration of the market, and those who want to survive and to compete, they need to become an omni-channel platforms where you provide your clients, usually to retail clients and then to corporates in the future, to be able to use any channel of your traditional banking services, but also any related and accompanying services. Not only payments, but it may be education and it may be your support in your tax commitments and any other services that are required to the small businesses and households, but also that is something that would be required in terms of cost saving to the big corporations. And this is something that you would be getting from the multi-channel institutions like the bank. And there you also need to have some fundamental machine that would be taking risks and would be providing the saving function to households and corporates, but would be making money on various other services like commission fees and the services that would be added to that platform. What is going to change in the next, even not 10 years, but 5 to 7 years, would be that not only the banking services would go away, but also some additional services would go away to be integrated into a multi-channel form, like those ATMs and everything else would be going online into your mobile applications, and we're going to issue more mobile applications in partnership with the companies from the other sectors. Thank you. I think you are more or less on the same tune with Piotr. Nothing extraordinary there, of course, but this is probably the way to go. Sergei, before discussing 5 to 7 years, let's look back a little bit. Out of the three banking functions, saving money or keeping money, taking part in settlements and providing for transactions, banks have been around as professional lenders for thousands of years. They also professionally offer money holding functions for 150 or 200 years, 200 years, and they have been participating in transactions only some decades. Now, at every point in the history of humanity, the lender must be professional. As soon as any risk would not have the owner, you would have various bad things happening. And that is why we are sticking to the simple idea. We know how to lend, and this is our bread and butter, and we are going to do the same in the coming 5 to 10 years or even 25 years. So we are a young team, and we're not going to change anything drastically. We can do this Well, we don't have 300 partnerships because of our size, maybe, but we know how to utilize and invest our capital, whatever it is, and we can also manage our credit risks quite well. We are not seeing anything in the market that may change the situation to us. There will always be better lenders with higher revenue and fewer losses. Any automation or any change in terms of situations would not really cause the disappearance of professional lenders. The past several thousand years actually did prove that. It's like, you know, trying to forecast the future. It is quite difficult, but all our strategies today are about staying and still being the professional lender, something that we can do better than others. In terms of the settlement and payment function, this is something new to the banking sector in general. I don't think that
практически не будут вообще принимать участие в расчетах. Это абсолютно возможно.
Well, I mean, I think that in 10 years banks would not be taking part in payments and settlements, and in fintech and also banks are developing their own
изменить, в принципе, весь
платформ. Crypto platforms and their own payment platforms, so they may change the course there. But to us, the mainstay in business is something that has been in demand in the past and several thousand years. And yes, of course, the banking sector has been around for several thousand years, although it has transformed a lot. In the past, you had only the Lombard approach with 120 collateral because the, of course, your cutlery of silver or gold could have been melted and transformed, or you only provided loans to your close ones, relatives and friends. And now we have a totally different attitude, also in terms of saving money and keeping the money. Even having a bank account, just some time in the past, was a sign of being quite wealthy. It all changed, but let's hope that it is going to continue. You do have a young team, and you are a team of co-owners and co-shareholders, and you are not really worried about the multipliers of your business, and we do respect that attitude. But Igor Yasinovets, maybe you can say a few words about that. As an independent expert, maybe you can provide a more independent view than the parties that are immediately involved in the banking business or being a regulator. Maybe I would not agree with Sergei that banking has been with us for long and will continue to be unchanged with us into the future. We do think that banking should expect many changes, depending, of course, on the particular sector of banking. Those subsectors that are about consumer lending and retail banking, those would be replaced by various online platforms, and there banks are going to lose their business there, either to kind of like mandating those businesses to the online platforms or otherwise. It might be different in terms of wealth management, where the role of customer relations will stay, and there banks have a better chance to use its good relations with the customer and using various technological solutions to protect such wealth management business. The third story would be about corporate banking, especially about the largest clients, where banks are going to lose their role in favor of working directly between the corporates in the market. And this is probably changing the value chain that we are going to see. So that future is going to be quite different, but also quite niche. We will be having fewer banks. There was an exhibition with the Kabakovs, which was named the future will not take you all on board, and I think that this is something that characterizes banks. Today, banks are losing their monopoly by 30-40% of their potential revenue. It's not that all this revenue would go away completely from banking. Maybe part of this revenue would be delegated to the customers and clients themselves as part of this technological change. Some of that revenue may be redistributed and reallocated between the banks, most of that would be received and taken on by the banks who are more innovative, but some of that revenue would be taken over by the technological platforms. Two global challenges here: the ability of banks to differentiate and to become different, and the level of digitalization was also quite of being different. Today it is more or less quite commonplace. What banks are going to be different between themselves? Not maybe in pricing and offering some tailored solutions is something that would differ banks, and some banks are lagging behind some of the technological advancements and also the rate of change. Banks today, as we can see, are very much different in their ability to quickly implement and deploy new ideas. Some can do this within 3 or 4 months, others can do that only within 12 months. And this is explained by the different level of competence and investment within the banks. Investment into the architecture and infrastructure. We're also saying that banks are becoming technological companies. Yes, but quite often banks are managed by people who are very far from being tech-savvy, and this is going to be another challenge to banks in their competition with the technological environment. Thank you. Well, indeed, so far, our speakers who are working in the banking sector have demonstrated their full confidence in the viability of banking and the banking sector and their banks, which is only the right way to go, of course. And I wouldn't expect anything else. And our independent expert, he was more of the opinion of the coming challenges from technological platforms that would not necessarily belong to banks, but to people who might have a banking license and then would take on some of the banking functions and roles. So life is becoming faster today and more technological, and it is not a given fact that old people would be able to adapt quickly to the new technologies. Colleagues, we're going to have a little poll among the audience, but let me take this opportunity to probably take a live poll with you. In your view, what would be the key challenges and dangers, if you like, or maybe surprises or something unexpected to banking? Maybe those would be coming from non-banking community, people who would be going into the banking business from the outside and be part of the new competition, or this might be some unexpected actions and decisions of the banking authorities and regulators, for example, or that may be something else. Global trends about the green economy, and this may
приведет к известным событиям у ваших заемщиков корпоративных, да, которым
change the position and the attitudes of your borrowers, etc. So it's a brief poll for you.
Ну, мне кажется, насчет вызов я уже сказал, мы все подтверждаем.
As I said, the key challenge for the management, and I'm not part of it, is to move from the top-down approach to the management based on partnerships, finding new ones and nurturing partnerships. That's a new model, that's a new approach. And another challenge is regulation. As I said, the landscape will evolve drastically. And those who used to be leaders 10 years ago have been now forgotten. The same applies to regulation. We are seeing regulatory arbitrage. We do have a lot of fintechs who don't are not subject to that stringent regulation, and they enjoy that leeway. There are different licenses, you know, electronic money in the UK. So this regulatory arbitrage is, for us and for the central bank, a major challenge. Tinkoff is not a systemically important bank, but you know, Raiffeisen is a systemically important bank, but Tinkoff is not. It means that there's been a delay in the decision-making process for the regulator. Ecosystem. The investments of the top 30 banks in non-financial organizations and non-core assets investment funds is 2.4 trillion rubles, 20% of capital. And it's only covered by 15% by regulatory capital. So it's a big question mark what to do with ecosystems. There's a lot of uncertainty. Regulators apply different approaches to regulating ecosystems. We don't want to buy up non-financial services, go on a shopping spree. We have a different strategy. But as for ECG, you know, several committees were set up in the US. And there might be a new add-on introduced in case ECG risks are materialized. Climatic crisis could bring losses for the banks up to 3% of GDP. And that's a new challenge. We don't know how to tackle it. So regulatory arbitrage is one, and a new management model is second, moving from top down to peer-to-peer partnerships. These are two challenges going forward. Thank you, colleagues.
Well,
Mikhail Zadarov, I would outline three challenges. First is competition from major IT companies, fintechs. That's kind of industry-specific disruption. But that's, you know, business as usual competition. There's always competition. We'll have to respond to it. Apple and Amazon had tried to launch their own financial services. They failed, but they will continue. We need to respond to it by providing new customers, new products and services to our customers. Second, it's cybersecurity and cybercrimes. Over the past 2 months, we've seen attacks against one of the major oil pipeline in the U.S. For almost a month, the healthcare system in Ireland has been struggling IT-wise. So we've seen these attempts. Banks have been historically more protected from such threats, but I would not rule them out. There might be targeted attacks against the banks, not just attempts to defraud people out of the money.
Такого банального ограбления до вытягивания денег у людей – это всегда такой привлекательный.
So banks have always been an appealing asset for criminals, and currently it's becoming increasingly more appealing target for cyber criminals. And this is why we need to come up with stronger security systems. We do have some experience in this. And third, unfortunately for the Russian market, we are subject to sanctions, and that's been artificially supported. There's no certainty around it. It's hanging over us like a cloud, and that's a huge challenge. And the sooner it disappears, the easier it will be to compete using ordinary, conventional tools. Yes, thank you. Over to you, Sergei. I fully subscribe to what Mikhail said. The level of uncertainty is extremely high. All the processes, both the technology, politics, and economy-wise, are accelerating. And we are seeing a new environment where agility and adaptability is becoming a key quality. A team that has the expertise and has the agility will win, and it's only people that define everything. How fast you respond to macroeconomic changes, to the regulators' actions, to moves from your competitors are critical. And in this regard, we're seeing more threats, they're very swift, and competition is becoming more exciting because the reward for being agile, for being competitive, is higher. So we're seeing more opportunities in this acceleration because it will kill smaller players and it will reward those who respond in a faster way. Very briefly, two more challenges. First, access to talents. Here in Russia, we have a fundamental deficit of people with new competencies, and the banks are definitely in a fight for these new competencies against other companies, other sectors, and very often a new generation would like to work at Yandex. They don't want to work at a bank, so access to this talent pool will shape success for the banks going forward. That's a huge issue. It's a systemic one. Some try to develop such competencies internally, but it is the challenge number one. Challenge number two, existing legacy banking structures. They're product segment-based, and in a way, they put you in a rut, in some kind of stale model. It's old thinking, and the banks will have to rethink the way they're structured. They, going forward, they could be split, differentiated by platforms, horizontally, not vertically by segments and product. So that's challenge number two. That will definitely have an impact on the industry. Thank you, colleagues. Now let's change gears. I'll have to ask our audience.
Два вопроса, да, им будет.
And there'll be two questions.
Голосование. Я прошу наших ассистентов.
Up for the poll. I'd like our assistants to help us.
Надо ли банку?
Number one.
В будущем становиться экосистемой?
Do banks need to become ecosystems in the future to be successful? Yes or no? As primitive as that. No third option.
Минута на голосование.
And you have 1 minute.
Вот от сердца. Первое, что пришло в голову, надо вот.
So any intuitive response off the top of your mind, whenever we do these 360, you know, performance sheets, or questionnaires, we're always asked to do everything off the top of your mind.
Узнать результаты опроса, это будет выведено, да? Отлично.
Will you put up the poll results on the screen? Yes.
Хорошо.
Quickly.
Я могу второй вопрос запустить?
Fine. Can we
run
the second poll?
Это уже не бинарное.
Good. We have more options.
Четыре варианта ответа.
Итак, вопрос. Кто может стать источником? Who can become the source of key changes?
Да, вот новое, локомотивом.
What are known as disruptors
на банковском рынке?
In the banking sector, 4 options here. Major banks,
fintechs,
big techs.
Third,
the regulator, like the government, and it's not just the Russian. Very often the trendsetters are not here in Russia. We have to follow suit.
And fourth, неизвестные игроки,
some unknown players, black swans.
Вот четыре варианта. Тоже выбирайте, пожалуйста, один.
Unknowns.
Две минуты голосования. Да, на самом
деле. So please choose one option.
Давайте две минуты дадим.
You have two minutes so that everyone has enough time to vote. Thank you.
Ну, пока, чтобы выиграть время, потому что пока...
So far, to win some time,
подведение итогов, это занимает время.
While votes are being processed, I'd like to say,
I'd
like to share some of the key takeaways from this debate. The key challenge, regardless of who becomes the source, regardless of who is the disruptor, the biggest challenge is acceleration of all the processes in our life. Life is so fast-paced, technology-wise, climate-wise, politically or economically, new skills. People just need to adapt very fast to be able to earn a living, and psychologically that's a heavy toll. For hundreds of years, people could have lived off just one profession. You could, like, a watchmaker, for example.
Гончар, там, менялись технологии, но они так вот...
A pulp maker.
Не так быстро менялись, хватало. Сейчас все это...
They could have learned one profession and used it throughout their life and even passed on to the next generation. And that was fine, that was enough. Now things change very fast, much faster. And regulators are seeing a lot of issues too. What are the basic regulatory principles in any state are the same? Very often we have contradictory goals. We want stability, predictability, but the world is facing uncertainty. It doesn't need to be too much a drag for, too much a barrier for the industry participants so they don't spend too much resources, too much time or money, and it also needs to be up to date. It has to be risk sensitive. It has to be real rather than artificial. And there are always contradictions. How can you have stability and predictability while the world is unpredictable? It's really hard to ensure predictability. Everyone wants to cut costs.
Книжного издания, книги в твердой обложке.
Take
все базовские документы
hard
и добавить еще тот
paper,
закон американский, выйдет hardback, нечто такое огромное, по объему кратно,
documents,
7-8 раз по объему превышающее известный четырехтомник «Войны и мира».
Только like if you publish the Dodd-Frank Act, it will be in hardback issue, it will be more than in volume than Leo Tolstoy's War and Peace. Okay, big text, 45%. I hope my eyesight is good enough to see that. So then you have the government, 18% in third, these are unknowns. And major banks are in fourth place. And we have representatives of major banks. You see, you are least expected to be a disruptor. Well, we are after stability and predictability, as you said earlier. That's really exciting. Again, I hope you can see that on your screen. That's really insightful. And as for ecosystems, my first question, could we go back to it?
У нас будет отдельная сессия по экосистемам, да, банковским. Может быть, там они, коллеги, продублируют, либо подстрахуют нас, даже если технически это...
We'll have more sessions, and I hope you can run the same poll there if it wasn't available here. Okay, we'll have a dedicated session on ecosystems.
Коллеги, вопрос этот решат. Ну, я закончу, да, вот.
Okay, I'd like to wrap it up. As I see it, as a regulator, mega regulator, and a monetary policy authority.
Что справиться вот с этими задачами
в условиях
непредсказуемости развития нашей жизни удастся нам всем только проявляя гибкость, адаптивность и
сотрудничество.
Постоянный диалог.
We need to strike partnerships. We need to be in close contact with the market participants.
Опять же, за мою долгую жизнь профессиональную, я считаю, что
I've had a long career, and
вообще с отсутствия диалога
in my tenure, that the quality of dialogue has improved, intensified, and I am extremely happy to see that.
Но надо будет вместе работать.
But we'll have to continue to work together. Otherwise, we won't be able to succeed. So I invite you to engage with the Central Bank, and I'd like to ask all of the panelists to share your expectations. There's one thing I realize. There's a strong demand from the market for these services, and we need to provide to our people, to you as representatives of this industry,
is
the level playing field, fair competition rules. We don't have that line as part of our law, but we're always guided by that, and there's stronger demand for it. Some of our colleagues talked about regulatory arbitrage. That's also a disruptor.
Накопленных уже вопросов
требуется. And there are other issues that we'll need to work on.
Дальше новые вопросы, которые будут
появляться. There will be definitely new issues emerging. We have 5 minutes left.
Сейчас мы проверим.
Now let's double check.
Сейчас мы проверим, поступили ли вопросы от наших.
Whether we have any questions from the audience.
Вот. Пока я вижу один.
So far, there's just one question.
Могут ли спикеры оценить
влияние? Could speakers provide their estimates?
Регулирование вложений в экосистемы.
Of
Я очень рад, что наш, так сказать, вот доклад консультативный.
Impact by the proposed regulation of ecosystems. Well, it's really great to see that the report we came up with has been very insightful, but we will have a session on that. So we'll put this question to the next speakers. Michael said there'll be a strong consolidation of the business in the next 10 to 15 years. Would it mean that there will only be space in the market for the biggest, those who have the biggest resources? That's the next question. So is there room for the good old face-to-face business model, client relationship, small segment, medium segment? So question on business models, that's number one. And second,
Выживаемость банков, ну ваш прогноз.
Will small banks survive? How many banks will we have in the next 10 years? Does it mean that competition will decline to the detriment of the business community and households? Very quickly, 2 points. We understand what the regulator means. They don't like to share how many banks there will be, but there's a myth. They say that so the smaller banks you have, the lower competition will be, but it's the other way around. The more this smaller list of banks you have, the tighter the competition. If you want to survive, you have to be strong. So competition is growing. So it doesn't really matter how many banks you have. But you always need to understand that it's only large-scale banks that can afford to adapt and change. But there will be niche players who will focus on specific services or sectors, and they could be pretty successful. And As for the second question, it was raised by Peter Arvin. The role of the regulator is important. Well, we say the banks have to be agile, but the regulator has to be agile internally too.
Классические банки или сейчас даже уже там финансовые группы не только со стороны регулятора центрального банка.
Financial groups are always pressurized by the regulator and the government. Like we need to monitor NGO payments or subsidize certain groups of population or certain enterprises. Well, it could be good, but in any case, also financial monitoring. Every mortgage transaction has to be reported and the date has to be accurate, otherwise you face a penalty. So we are seeing a lot of burden. But when new player, when there are new entrants in the market, there has to be level playing field. You can't demand too much from the banks, but when you have new disruptors, you provide benefits to them. There's this balance. This is why the government and the central bank has to respond. Take China, Alibaba, Jack Ma, and the new financial service. That was a regulatory issue, right? Not just a business issue. Yes, fair competition, level playing field, going back to it, including for the new entrants from other sectors, from other industries. This is important for us, as I said, I'd like to reiterate this. As for the extra burden, which is not quite a core activity for the banking community, the government definitely needs to use the sense of measure, but it's inevitable that you'll have to do this. You have to assume these extra responsibilities. The banking business will be a special kind of business because your role in society is extremely important. You'll be able to use new technology, access to databases, and the consequences of any banks failing is too high. So it's a kind of a conflict or a paradox. So you definitely play a huge role in people's lives, and this is why I'll always be on the radar. There needs to be dialogue, but you have to put up with more responsibilities. It's not just the Russian trend. It's like banking secrecy. It doesn't really exist anymore the way we knew it 50 years ago. It simply doesn't exist, particularly given the cyber criminals out there and all the hacks that we've seen. So as you can see, time is coming to an end. Unfortunately, we didn't have too much time to outline our opinion. Nevertheless, I've learned a lot during this discussion, and we'll continue working. I know that we will succeed, we will prevail. Thank you. I wish you to take part in other sessions too.